Debouncing user input in a SwiftUI searchable field can be surprisingly challenging. SwiftUI updates the search text instantly with every keystroke, which can quickly lead to performance issues, especially if you're triggering a network request or heavy filtering logic. Because of SwiftUI declarative updates and lack of built-in debouncing, implementing a smooth and efficient search experience requires a bit of extra work. In this video, I will guide you step-by-step through the exact process of adding debouncing to a searchable field in SwiftUI, so you can build a fast, responsive search that feels just right. Make sure to check out the link in the description for a discounted price on my SwiftUI camp where you can learn SwiftUI in 4 weeks. More on this in the video. Okay, so today we are going to take it further from our previous episode about debouncing text in SwiftUI. What we have currently is we have a text field and we have a text that is tied to the text field and a debounced text that is using the debounced view modifier that we created in our previous episode. Make sure to check it out if you haven't already done so. The link for the playlist is down in the description. Okay, so what we have over here is that if we just type in something, it will just wait for 1 second. It will debounce it for 1 second and then you can call upon it on your server. Currently, I'm just displaying it right over here. So if I just type out here a long text, it will just wait till I stop, and then after 1 second it will just send it to our servers, which is really great. This is how you should handle searches through a text field. But what happens if you are having an actual searchable on SwiftUI? We can just do the debounce also, but let's just make it a little bit easier on ourselves. So I'm just going to comment this out. We are no longer going to need this one. So the text field, we are going to add a searchable. So right over here on the scroll view, let's have a searchable, and we're going to use the simplest one with just a simple text. And yeah, it's a text, great. We have that view modifier and then a debounce text. And then what we would do if we want to present it initially, if instantly, we would just have this text on change of on the text, and then we just put the debounce text for that new value. Let's just see how that looks like. So actually, this is not what we want, basically, because this is instant, so it's not debouncing. As you can see, it's as I type, it's just going to replace it. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, let me just comment this out for that matter. Okay, so what do we want? Well, we have our text over here, so why not use the debounced view modifier also? Let's just have that. So when we are debouncing on the text, we just have the debounced text. Yeah, that's right. Let's build and run. And let's see that. Ready to take your SwiftUI skills to the next level? SwiftUI Camp, my best-selling cohort-based Zoom bootcamp, is the fastest way to get there. For a limited time, you can join at 80% off until May the 7th. Over 4 weeks, you'll get hands-on expert guidance to help you master SwiftUI and build production-ready iOS apps with confidence. Whether you're aiming to launch your own app or land your next developer role, this is your chance to level up. Grab your spot now. Discounted link is in the description. So now if I just type in E, after 1 second, it's there. Yeah, that's great. And then just go another one, and then another one. And I just type, wait for 1 second. There it is, which is great. It's fine, but we have to take care of the text on the searchable. And also we have this debounced text right over here. I want to make it a little bit easier for you. Yeah, that's why we have this next video. Otherwise, you can just take it from the previous one. So instead of having this searchable and the debounced text, I'm just going to copy this out and create, and let's just also comment it out. And let's create a new view modifier that will be debounced searchable modifier. So let's go back to our debounced text input and let's create a new view modifier right over here. So view modifier, and let's call this debounced searchable modifier. There we go. Okay, I don't care about the preview. I'm going to I'm going to remove it. And then instead of this padding and the background, I'm going to paste in the searchable with text and the debounced. Of course, you do need some text and the debounced text. Let's think a bit about it a little bit. Here's the text. Well, that's kind of internal at this point. So we are going to have a state private var that will be our text. And of course, it will be of type string, and empty string is by default. And then we want to bind this with the debound text. We don't care about the actual text that we are typing in into the searchable, you know, the search bar. And we just care about the debound text. So we are going to have bound debounced text and also the debounced seconds. So we have also access to that variable, that time interval. So now we are going to have debounced text, and then we are going to have our debounced seconds. Yeah, there we go. Debounced. Oh, we have a typo also there, so let's just have our debounced seconds, and right over there, and then seconds, and seconds. There we go, real nice. Okay, so we have our debounced view modifier right over here. Let's create an extension for it. So extension on the view, let's just call this searchable function, of course. Searchable debounced debounced text. Yeah, this looks right. Okay, and the modifier. But I'm going to remove this because we already have the debounced text property name right over here, and it should look okay. Now, let's go back to our content view. Instead of these two lines, we're just going to have searchable, and we're going to use the one with the debounced text. That's right. So now we don't even need this state variable of that string. And still we are going to print it out on the view, on the text. So let's build and run and see how that looks like. Let's just start over there and start typing. There we go. And now after 1 second, it's right over there. Great. So, okay, but actually what we want is to just call on an API, and we don't do that. We just instantly present it, well, instantly after 1 second, present it on the debounced text view. So for that, what we would need is listen, so on change of the debounced text, and then on, we don't care about the old value, we would just, currently I'm just going to print out our new value. Let's see how that looks like. So yeah, basically that's fine. So if I just type in a letter right over here after 1 second, as you can see, it just printed it out. So what that means is that we can call upon our API. That's great, but again, it is two lines of code. So yeah, it's cumbersome. So let's go ahead and create a new view modifier, which will have a completion instead, which kind of encompasses these two. So let's just create our own, let's just create our on debounce searchable. So I'm just going to copy this out and create a new view modifier right over here. And then not the debounced searchable, but on debounce searchable view modifier. And let's just have the plain old searchable and the debounced too, so that's fine. Of course, we also need these properties. There we go. And then we are going to also include this. Coming back, we don't need the debounced text at this point because the debounced text should be inside our view modifier because we don't actually need it. So let's just do that. The debounced seconds, it's fine, but instead we need a completion. As I told you, we just want to go outside. So we are going to have a let on debounce. debounce, and that will, or debounced, let's just call it debounced, and that will be a completion that will give us back a string value. So now we can listen what we did previously. So on change of that debounced text, and then we are going to grab our new value and say on debounced and then new value. So we are going to have that completion. Okay, now let's create a new view modifier. So an extension on the view. Extension on view. And let's just see. Yeah, this is fine. This is really, really great. And let me just have that. And let's just use our timing table to be added as the first one. So 4. And then debounced time interval. Of course, we do have a 1 second added. And let's just see on debounced view modifier, what's going on over here? Let's just fix that. Yeah, debounced seconds is the debounced seconds, and on debounced. Really great. So now we can just go back to our content view. Instead of these two lines, we can now have this on, what was its name? let's just see it. Oh, it's searchable 4. Let's just see searchable 4 dot searchable 4 on debounce. Yeah, we can also have this on debounce if that is the case. And then we can just have, we are going to have a value in, and then we can just print it out. Print out our value. Now let's come back and build and run and see that if I just type something in here, that's an E, after 1 second it has been printing out. Printing it out right over here inside the completion is really important, because this is where you are going to send it to that API to, you know, just search on your database. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out the discounted link in the description where you can find SwiftUI Camp and you can master SwiftUI in 4 weeks.